Hi everybody, Dan Illman, Matt Bernier. The DRF bets Friday race of the day for May the 11th, race number 2 at Santa Anita. We kick off the early pick 4 with a 2-year-old race. 5 fillies, 3 colts, only one has raced before. You can bet the pick 4 with DRF bets. Sign up for a new account, access a $150 bonus. Just go to drf.com/join and type in the promo code TV150. Let's take a look at the field of babies getting set to sprint at the Great Race Place. Download those free Formulator Pass performances. Kind of essential with all the pedigree and trainer information you get. You can get them at the Race of the Day event page at drf.com. Download them, handicap along with Matt and I. We'll take this field in post position order. Matt, the number one is Watch Me Burn. This is a $20,000 yearling purchase by Hold Me Back. There's some speed in this family.
Yeah, there is. I have to be honest, the speed at 4.5, 2-year-old, that's always going to be important. Breaking from the rail, you're going to have a little bit of gas if you want to get out of there in decent enough order. I have to be honest, I feel like this is one of the more modest pedigrees of this entire bunch. There is some speed, but I don't know how much, I don't want to say how much quality there is, but we don't have any giant numbers or giant family members in here like there are with some of these other horses. But again, good early speed, I think, is going to be very important for this horse to get out there and try to establish some early position. And you know what? The connections, they've done okay in the past with these types.
13% 2-year-old debut winners for the sire, Hold Me Back. The dam's a half sister to Latent Revenge. We know Latent Revenge is a very fast turf sprinter, a lot of early speed. He's grade 3 stakes placed. Dam's also a half to a stakes winning dirt sprinter named BG Suavecito, who won his debut at 2. Second dam was a multiple stakes winning sprinter that won the debut at 2. So there is some precocity. We'll see about the class. The 2 is Sparkyville. Sparkyville was a $170,000 yearling buyback. This one's by Candy Ride. Big family. Mike Smith takes them out.
Yeah, Candy Ride's 13.5% with the 2-year-old first-time starters. Find it interesting that Smith takes the mount going out for Bondi whenever they've teamed up past 5 years in dirt sprints. 7-for-10 with a 480 ROI. Most of those in graded stakes races, though. The dam is a half to Graham Hall, 3/4 to Harmony Lodge. They're both graded stakes winners. There's a lot of quality in here, and I find it fascinating that Smith sees fit to take this mount on a 2-year-old first-time starter. I think that's interesting.
The buzz horse in this race is the number 3, Tajori. This is from the first crop of Will Take Charge, who's been through the auction ring 3 times. A $130,000 weanling who sold up for $260,000 as a yearling and then sold all the way up to $525,000 a couple of months ago after breezing a furlong in 10 seconds flat. Now, you look at the bottom of this pedigree, you think distance.
I was going to say, you got Broken Vow down on the dam side. The dam herself was 1-for-2 as a 2-year-old. Will Take Charge is one of my favorites over the past handful of years. But we know what his real game was going long. We'll find out what he passes on to his progeny. You brought it up. The horse has been working well. There's been a little bit of buzz. You can see, obviously, with the price tag. Wouldn't surprise me at all if this horse comes out running, and Simon Callahan's off to a good start at this Santa Anita meeting.
This horse is a half to Chip Leader, a grade 3 place dirt router recently. Think placed in the Benelai going 9 furlongs. This horse did win his career debut at 2, Chip Leader, but on the turf going long. Tajori, a lot of buzz. Interesting to see the 5 furlong workout. You rarely see those with these 2-year-olds going 4.5 furlongs. Trainer Doug O'Neill does surprisingly well with these kind of horses. He has 2 entered here for Team Redham. We'll begin with the 4, Factor of 2, a $35,000 yearling who sold up for $80,000 last month after working a furlong in 10-1. Here's the formulator fact for Factor of 2. Over the past 4 years, with 2-year-old first-time starters and maiden special weight dirt sprints, 28%, a 318 ROI. But the formulator fact we'll show a little bit later on might actually make this one look bad.
It's going to be interesting to see what you get. I'm fascinated by Doug O'Neill, and you can tweak things. And like you say, we've got another formulator fact coming, and I'll bring up my little piece later on. The factor, 9% with the 2-year-old firsters. I prefer the factor generally on turf as opposed to dirt. This horse is a half to All Indians, who is 1-for-5 as a 2-year-old. So a little bit of precocity on the bottom side. You see Dubai makes me think more middle distance. And again, whenever I see the factor, I'm generally more intrigued when we see him on grass as opposed to dirt.
Hunray stands a half to a couple of stakes place turf sprinters in Japan. The number five is Honcho, one of two in here, trained by Michael McCarthy. Honcho, a $50,000 buyback as a yearling, is one of two in here by Street Boss. And Street Boss is one of the great underrated precocious stallions. He wins 21% of the time with his debuting two-year-olds, and this dams a half to a pretty precocious and nice horse in the graded stakes winning turf runner Conquest Daddy-O.
Yeah, agreed. Like you say, half to Conquest Daddy-O. The dam is, the dam herself was 0 for 3 as a two-year-old, excuse me. But you bring in the Street Boss factor. You bring in the fact that there is a nice horse on the dam side with a little bit of precocity. I do wonder a little bit. Street Boss, not only is he underrated for the precociousness, but Street Boss actually does better with the progeny going long. So I wonder if this is a horse you... We talked about Conquest Daddy-O. He did most of his best running going longer. I wonder if this is one that'll take time with a little bit of additional distance.
And the dam's also a half to a stakes winning turf router named Hanging by a Thread. So there is that distance on the bottom of the pedigree. The only horse with prior racing experience is the number six, Zip's Secret. And Zip's Secret only sold for $5,000 despite having a very strong pedigree. The dam's a half to a multiple grade one stakes winning router named Love and Pride. The second dam is a grade one stakes placed half to Bernardini. So maybe they got a bargain here. And if you watch this filly's debut, she didn't break, was steadied in the opening furlong, and then was professional while non-threatening after that.
And you get Lasix this time around for the first time in the second lifetime start. It's going to be fascinating to see. We always see those baby races at Keeneland. The horses are usually cranked up and ready to go. The fascinating thing is you're going to get out to Southern California. We always talk about it. California speed is different than basically everywhere else. But the fact that this one already has done something in the afternoon and the rest of these boys and girls are trying that for the first time, that experience can be invaluable.
The number seven is Overemphasize, also trained by Michael McCarthy. This is a $9,500 weanling purchase that sold up for $40,000 as a Keeneland September yearling. Overanalyzed has done very, very well with two-year-old debut runners, clicking at a 19% clip. And this horse is a half to a stakes-winning sprinter, albeit over a synthetic surface.
Yeah, half to a couple of two-year-old winners. I kind of look at this overall. Michael McCarthy does a little bit better, I think, with a little bit of time. Past 5 years dirt, two-year-old first-time starter sprinting over 16-7 in the money. So another one that I'd like to see, as good as the pedigree would suggest with the overanalyzed piece, as well as the precociousness on the bottom. I wonder if second time out is going
to
be better.
The dam is a half to four black-type earners. Let's look at the number eight, Toothless Wonder. We'll throw up the formulator fact I have for O'Neill. Past 5 years, two-year-old first-time starters, maiden special weight dirt sprints at Santa Anita with Mario Gutierrez aboard, 33%, 372 ROI. Something tells me Mario's on this one. This is the preferred one.
Yeah, this is obviously the outfit altogether. O'Neill, Redham, Gutierrez. We've seen success in the Kentucky Derby. We'd all have another Nyquist. Another little bit of a tweak for a formulator fact. For me, specifically, and you can go through and you can filter by distance, these four and a half races are for the early two-year-olds. Past 3 years, two-year-old first-time starters at four and a half furlongs for O'Neill. 7 for 16, 14 of them in the money with the 302 ROI. So I think in general, he does better with these two-year-olds when they're early, where maybe some of the other larger operations are waiting until we get to Del Mar or waiting until we get later at Santa Anita to unveil their horses at 5 and 6 furlongs. Again, Street Boss is here. This horse is a half to the money monster, who is a multiple stakes winner. The outside draw, I think, is invaluable in a race like this as well, where you know what? You break a little bit outside, no worries. You don't have to worry about anything, and you can take up a decent enough stalking position, perhaps a little bit light on the work tab, but that most recent gate drill in 48-1, I think that's a positive.
Money Monster, very fast, won his career debut. The second dam was graded placed. She won her debut. This horse worked in 10-1 before selling for $220,000. So Toothless Wonder looks live. And as we take a look at our top selections for the Friday DRF Bets Race of the Day, that's where you're going. The Toothless Wonder, the number eight, Doug O'Neill. Give me numbers.
I'd love to know the story behind the name, too. 823 for me. I just think that outside draw, with all the positives that we threw out as far as formulator facts are concerned, the two I'm fascinated with, that teaming up of Bondi and Smith with a firster, because usually Smith rides when you've got a good graded stakes caliber runners for Jeff Bondi. And then I like the three, the horse that you're interested in as well, Tajuri. So I'm going to go 823.
Tajuri's the horse that a lot of folks have been talking about. I think it's nice to see Pratt take the mount for Simon Callahan. A little bit worried that maybe distance down the road, but I've heard some good things about this filly. She'll be my top pick. I think Honcho's going to run well. The other street boss, the number five for McCarthy. We mentioned the dam won five times, a half to Conquest Daddy-O. Overemphasized, the seven is my third pick by Overanalyze. We talked about his success. And then Toothless Wonder, the eight. 3, 5, 7, and 8 for me. To kick off the early pick four at the Great Race Place on Friday afternoon, and no better place to bet that pick four than with DRF Bets and your own DRF Bets account. Sign up, get $150. DRF.com/join, promo code TV150. The babies will be off and running for race number two at Santa Anita on Friday, approximate post time, 1 o'clock Pacific. Best of luck.